All right, so you probably opened that refrigerator already, and you notice that, hey, I've got a turkey carcass in there. What do I do with it besides make a sandwich? Well, joining us now, Chef Michael Powers. He's from Terrace Restaurant. You got a really cool approach to using that leftover turkey. What are we making here?
We're making jambalaya today.
With turkey?
With turkey, yeah. Instead of chicken, we're going to use some of those leftover Thanksgiving.
Sweet.
Add-ons. So what we do is we start with some prawns. It's really easy.
Very good.
So get those going.
What kind of oil are we using here? Just
We're using a blend, some canola and olive oil.
Okay, very good.
So just waiting for that to heat up a little bit.
All right.
So next we're going to do some andouille sausage. Mm.
You can't go wrong with the andouille sausage.
Oh, yeah. Fantastic. Sausage is always a plus.
Okay.
Then you want to go ahead and throw in some of your leftover turkey.
Does it matter, dark meat or light meat or what?
You know, it doesn't matter at all. It's just pretty much what you prefer.
Yeah.
So I kind of get a little bit of both in there, you know, just for added flavor.
Absolutely.
And then we go from there into some red onions, a little bell pepper.
Beautiful. Do you rather than the green, do you do the yellow and the red for extra color, or is the flavor like vary that much?
It varies a little bit.
Okay.
I prefer the red and the yellow both for color and flavor. It's just a preference thing.
Just a preference,
you know,
absolutely.
If you want to use green.
They seem they're a little sweeter, probably, aren't they?
Yes,
the green?
They are.
Okay.
And so you just want to saute that a little bit until it starts getting a little translucent.
Okay.
A little salt, a little pepper.
Okay.
A little pinch of garlic.
Very nice.
And then you want to add some Cajun spice. And this is actually just a mixture of paprika, chili powder, and cayenne.
Okay, so
pepper.
Is that spicy?
It's like a mild spice.
Okay.
I mean, you can definitely range it.
Sure.
You know,
Your preference.
Yeah, I like things spicy, so,
looks
you know,
so good.
I add a little more cayenne. So then we have a little bit of cilantro.
Oh, cilantro. I thought that was flat leaf parsley.
Yeah.
That's interesting. Love that flavor.
And then once that's down, you want to deglaze with a little white wine.
Mm-hmm.
You can go ahead and add your rice. You know, I always have rice. I have three kids, so I got rice around the house constantly.
All the time. Hey, question for you while you're mixing this up.
Okay.
You say add the white wine. Should it always be Chardonnay, or could you use something like a different kind of white wine if you wanted?
Yeah, it's pretty much what you prefer.
Yeah.
You know, if you have your favorite bottle of white wine with you while you're drinking it, go ahead and use that.
Okay, very good.
So they always say cook with something that you would drink.
That you would drink,
or that you prefer.
Very good.
Okay, and then the last thing is to go ahead and add a little bit of chicken stock.
And at Terrace, you guys always use real chicken stock, correct?
Oh,
not
yes.
The
oh,
canned
yes.
chicken stock, which can work at home, but it is so much better if you can make your own.
Yeah, if you can, then it would be better, but, you know, you can always pick up some good chicken stock at the grocery store. So you go ahead and
cilantro.
That? That's actually flat leaf parsley.
Okay.
Just for the color aspect. And then at the last end, you want to add some butter.
Okay.
And that will help thicken it up a little bit.
Okay. Wow. And this is so quick, too. What's nice about this quick, because shrimp takes such a short time to cook. The andouille sausage is already cooked, so you're just kind of warming it up. Your turkey's already cooked, so you're just kind of warming. I mean, this is, look at you, you're done.
Yeah, I mean, literally 5 minutes. You basically just want to wait until the juice absorbs into the rice. So we can go ahead and start plating this a little bit early here while this is going.
While you're plating this, and explain, what traditional jambalaya mm-hmm. is made with what? Traditional.
Traditional would be chicken,
mm-hmm.
Sausage, normally some ham, and then prawns or seafood, whatever you prefer.
Okay, so your variation is just the turkey makes it different.
Yeah, that's just a different holiday experience for jambalaya. You know, and that way you get to utilize your leftovers other than a hot turkey sandwich, you know.
Mm-hmm. And it's a beautiful dish, too. I mean, it is absolutely beautiful. So I've got a fork here. And let's try this real fast, if I might, and see how this tastes. So get a little bit of turkey, a little bit of spice, a little sausage. I could eat that for dinner, for lunch, you name it.
Good,
That's
good.
Really good.
Thank you very much.
That was real dumb for me to eat while I have to talk. We're going to post this link to this recipe on our website, kcra.com.